Hi, I'm Scott Shipe. I'm with Water Advocacy. I have the Water Knowledge Academy. I'd like to talk to you today about the Sump Pump Amnesty Program. The Sump Pump Amnesty Program basically is an incentive to get your family homeowners that have sump pumps to disconnect from the sewer system permanently. This is a logical way to get the homeowner to unhook your sump pumps. It's a huge issue. I want to talk to you about how much flow that derives from sump pumps. An 8-inch sanitary sewer is designed for waste flows from up to 200 homes. 18 sump pumps operating at full capacity will overload the same 8-inch line. So I've seen actually less than that. I mean, if it's a large sump pump, it'll choke an 8-inch easily. If you have a 4, 5, or 6-inch rain event, and it's just overwhelming where the plant is going to, the plant's going to overflow almost. The water is just going to really. It's the UV light or the disinfection system can't handle this type of hydraulics, so you're going to have major issues. Again, you read your soil maps and you go out and look where your groundwater table is in your neighborhoods, why are you hiring all these consultants if you're not doing this task when they're out there studying your system? I mean, this is probably one of the number one priorities to go out and determine and figure out our sump pump. I still see people that do these big relining projects and sanitary sewer projects, but they still have these astronomical flows during wet events. Well, it's obvious that the water is coming from sump pumps. Are you kidding me? And the millions of dollars people spend on doing these projects, and they really don't even understand the scope of what they're really trying to do, because the water actually is coming from the private side. It's not coming from the public utility. Again, you do these big projects, and then no one follows up to basically do the state's mandating you do projects, but I don't think even the state knows what they're mandating they want you to do. So this is probably, there's a few states that actually understand that this is a huge issue, and they have a funding mechanism and certainly work with utility. But I would suggest, you basically do these sump pumps. It's simple as having a plumber go in the house, running the effluent line out from the sump pump to a swaleway or structure in the yard that's perforated. And, you got to know where the water table is, and it's out of sight, out of mind. And certainly landscape, put the property back the way you found it. But, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, depends on your area. You can put in a perforated structure or plumb these sump pumps out. It depends on your area of the country on what your construction cost is. Or you could do it yourself, working with a plumber to get in the property. But I just find it ironic that this is probably one of the biggest problems that utilities face. And it's easy as reading your soil maps, knowing where your groundwater table is in these areas where historically you have sump pumps. If you do manhole inspection programs, you actually can hear the pumps come on echoing down the sewers. I mean, are you kidding me? And nobody, I just find it amazing. You can hear the pumps, and certainly in the daytime, even inspecting manholes, you can actually see that clear water pulsing through your sewer in these neighborhoods where these sump pumps are. So again, what I've experienced is people do not want you to enter their house, tell them to unhook a sump pump, because they're just going to attach it back, and they certainly are going to go to your local political leader and put political heat on you, and your director is going to melt because he wants to keep that job, and this is a very political situation. Tens of millions of dollars of people treating water. Say you have 100 sump pumps in a period of 10, 20 years, it's just a mind-boggling. I mean, just go back and look at the flow records after you do a major lining project, and you're ramping the water back up in these people's homes, and you don't take that in consideration, and you actually probably are getting more sump pumps, and people are adding sump pumps to their house after these projects because the water tables come up, because for all those years the water alleviated itself in the sewer, so you really aren't gaining much with doing these projects without removing these sump pumps. I mean, are you kidding me? Who are these engineers? But again, there's a certainly Massachusetts DEP understands this. They're pretty I think on point with this program. Certainly it's probably one of the biggest things you can do to reduce that big spike off your plant when you get these 3, 4, 5, 6 inch rain events that occur. And in recent years, I mean, we're getting some months with, up to 11, 10, 12 inches of rain in a month. So there's a lot of water that people are pumping into your system. And you should know that. I mean, you should know where that water, by just putting a televising camera and a CCTV camera in your line, you're going to know. You can sit out at that lateral and just watch it pause in the wet times. Yeah, you're going to have to go out there in the rain. It's easy as putting the camera in line and parking it at the lateral connection point. And you're going to see this water pulsing up and down, up and down, up and down. And again, there's no one home. It's just a no-brainer. It's probably one of the biggest issues that utilities ignore because of the politics involved, the political ramification. But it's all about the leadership, and you got to get out there and work with your folks and basically give them a public education, take them to the plant, and certainly in your community centers, go out and show them what goes on with a logical PowerPoint presentation and why you want to do this program. And I think most people will work with you. I mean, if you can eliminate 80 to 90% of these, you're going to still have a couple that are problem folks. But again, if you would have been doing this up front from the beginning, the inspecting your system, you would know this. So it's really kind of your fault that these sump pumps are there. And the longer they're there, it's kind of like a walking easement on your property. You let somebody walk across your property for 30 years and you never put a fence up or stopped them, it's kind of like that. It's kind of funny. But anyway, I'm just trying to give you some incentives of things that I've learned and things that'll save you millions and millions of dollars in cost to treat that water, pump that water, and certainly it's going to take you out of compliance during the wet times of the year to meet your goals of your nitrogen and certainly your suspended solids in your total flow. And it's going to actually change the chemistry, whatever the groundwater is. It's certainly going to change the chemistry of the biology at your plant when this occurs, and the biology is going to be upset at your plant during these high hydraulics that occur during these events. So anyway, Scott Shipe, talk about the Sump Pump Amnesty Program. It's a great way to eliminate a lot of water from your system, and it's very inexpensive to do this program once and for all, because again, it's all about being a leader and going out there and fixing these kind of issues in your utility. So anyway, I hope you found this beneficial, and have a great day. Thank you.